Hello friends, welcome back to Muluk IAS. Now we were discussing the class 7 NCERT for geography, and this is a part 2 which I would be discussing right now. Those students who want to purchase NCERT synopsis for all classes from class 6 to class 12, now no need to read 42 NCERTs, you can read only 5 NCERTs and that would be sufficient. जैसे हमने क्लास 6 से लेके क्लास 10 तक की एक ही बुक में कवर किया हुआ है. फॉर एग्जांपल क्लास 6 ओनली 15 पेज में ख़त्म हो गया था, क्लास 7 ओनली 19 पेजेस हुई है कवरिंग. तो उसी हिसाब से आपको काफ़ी ज़्यादा आसान रहेगा टू कवर एनसीईआरटीज, टू रिवाइज दोज एनसीईआरटीज टाइम एंड अगेन बाई फॉलोइंग दीज एनसीईआरटी सिनॉप्सिस ओनली. तो कंटिन्यू करते हैं पार्ट 2 क्लास 7th का. We will have to start from chapter number 7. यहाँ से शुरू करेंगे. 1 to 6 हमारा already cover हो चुका था. The chapter number 7 is the human environment, settlement, transport and communication. Friends, there is a long stretch of the communications that have been established around the world, and there are different ways of communication. For example, there are major sea and airports that are there. Air routes are there, sea routes are there. You have to just go through that, what are the major routes that are there. साथ में ही जैसे आपको पहले बताया हुआ है, I have taken up a class for geography mapping. That class is available on the YouTube channel of Muluk IAS also. You can do these important towns and connectivity and कुछ और आसपास का जो भी है उस areas में, region में, तो वो already आप वहाँ से cover कर सकते हैं. When you talk about settlements, friends, settlements, it can be either temporary or it can be a permanent. For example, rural area mein ho sakte hain aap, ya aap urban area mein ho sakte hain. Rural area mein aap isolated bhi reh sakte hain dwelling. But there can also be a compact settlement that can be there. To better understand the difference between the two, for example, isolated settlements. Isolated or scattered settlements are basically found in the hilly areas mein ho sakta hai, thick forest mein ho sakta hai, ya regions of the climate extremes wahan pe aapko mil sakta hai. And the population will be comparatively less over here. On the other hand, compact settlement kahan pe hota hai? They are basically found in the plain areas which are comparatively more fertile. Or is time pe the settlement is the build-up of the area is comparatively compact. And the inter-house distance, दो घरों में distance comparatively कम होगा. अगर area productive है, plain area है, the population is bound to be more. Different ways of transport is also there. For example, roadways, railways, waterways, airways, communication, etc. can be there. Roadways की बात करते, there can be metal road, there can be unmetal road. Waterways ki, there can be inland waterways and there can also be various sea routes that can be established. Next is chapter number 8, focusing upon human environment interactions, the tropical and the subtropical regions that are there. Basically, chapter is talking about the Amazon basin, life in the Amazon basin, that is basically 10 degree north to 10 degree south ke beech mein jo hai. What is important is what is the type of flora, fauna, what is the people of the rainforest, they are basically engaged into activities and uske bare mein pucha gaya hai, alag alag regions ke bare mein. Starting off with the life in the Amazon basin, 10 degree north or south ke beech mein. The climate is hot and wet climate, yahan pe aapko milega. The days and nights are almost of the equal hot and equally hot and humid. The rain is almost every day there is raining. At night the temperature will be down but the humidity will remain high. Flora or fauna ki jab baat karte hain, it would be thick forest that would be there because of the good amount of rainfall that is there. Different birds such as toucans, hummingbirds, birds of paradise with a brilliantly colored plumage, they will be found in this region. Crocodiles, snakes, pythons will be there. Anaconda and boa constrictors are also there. Several species of fishes including the flesh-eating piranha fish, they are basically being found in this region. The people, they basically men, they hunt and fish along the river. The women, it is they who would be taking care of the crops. The agriculture would be slash and burn agriculture that would be present. There are large apartments like houses for they are called as maloka with a steeply slanting roof. So aapko pucha ja sakta hai ki maloka kya hota. They are basically the large apartments which are there, where there would be steep slanting roof. So usko bolte hain maloka. Next is life in the Ganga Brahmaputra basin. Basically lies in the subtropical region jo yahan pe lie karte hain. And it is situated between 10 degree north and 30 degree north. 10 और 30 degree north की बात हो रही है. यहाँ पे मॉनसून क्लाइमेट आपको देखने को मिलेगा, जहाँ जून से लेके सितंबर तक आपको बारिश देखने को मिलती है. द लैंड इज़ कंपेरेटिवली फर्टाइल. एग्रीकल्चर में इट इज़ बेसिकली द पैडी दैट इज़ डोमिनेंट मेनली, बट अदर क्रॉप्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल वीट हो गया, मेज हो गया, सोरगम हो गया, ग्राम हो गया, मिलेट्स हो गए, और फॉर एग्जाम्पल बनाना कल्टिवेशन दे आर ऑल्सो बींग फाउंड. सिल्क इज ऑल्सो फाउंड इन द बिहार एंड इन आसाम. इट इज़ बैम्बू दैट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट. इन पार्ट्स ऑफ उत्तराखंड, सिक्किम एंड अरुणाचल प्रदेश यू हैपन टू फाइंड वेरियस कॉनिफरस ट्रीज, जो कोन्स की तरह उनके होते बने होते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल पाइन ट्री, फॉर एग्जाम्पल देवदार एंड फर ट्रीज, दे आर बेसिकली बींग फाउंड. इंपॉर्टेंट एनिमल्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल एलिफेंट, टाइगर, डियर, मंकी, दे आर बींग फाउंड. One horned rhinoceros is an important feature of the Brahmaputra plain that is there. In the delta region, it would be Bengal tiger, crocodile and alligators they are found. The various important popular varieties of the fish, for example, rohu, katla and hilsa. Ek baar question aa chuka hai, ye kya hota hai? They are basically different varieties of the fish that are being found. The fresh water of river Ganga and river Brahmaputra also contains a variety of a locally susu, that locally called susu, also called a blind dolphin, is also found in this region. Jisko hum locally bolte hain susu. Chapter number 9 pe aate hain. Life in the temperate grassland. Ki temperate grassland, for example, prairies. Prairies aapko kahan pe paaye jaate hain? They are basically being found in Northern America. The prairies, they are basically, jab geographically dekhte hain, they are bound by the Rocky Mountains in the west and they are great lakes that are there in the east. The prairies, they are covering a good part of United States of America and also parts of Canada too. In US, when you talk about the area is drained by the tributaries of Mississippi, the Canadian prairies are basically drained by the tributaries of Saskatchewan River. US में मिसिसिपी और कनाडा में सस्कैचुआन रिवर वो इनको ड्रेन करते हैं. द ग्रासलैंड्स विच आर देयर ऑफ द प्रेरीज, दे आर बेसिकली द होम ऑफ द नेटिव अमेरिकन्स एंड दे आर ऑफन कॉल्ड एज रेड इंडियंस. डिफरेंट ट्राइब्स दैट दे आर फाउंड, फॉर एग्जांपल अपाचे, क्रो, क्री एंड पौनी, दे आर बेसिकली फाउंड इन द प्रेरीज रीजन. ये वाला एरिया आपको प्रेरीज का है, कनाडा और US में पाया जाता है. It is over here that Saskatchewan River is basically being found. और यहाँ पर basically Mississippi और इसकी rivers है जो आपको वहाँ पर देखने को मिलती है. Next is the climate, the flora and basically the people of this region, they are in question too. The climate is basically the continental type because with extreme temperature that would be found. Approximately 20 degrees C, that would be the temperature that would be there. Annual rainfall would be moderate and the hot wind that is blowing in this region is basically a Chinook. Chinook is basically a hot wind that is flowing in this region, that is important. तो आपको ये भी पूछा जा सकता है Chinook wind कहाँ पे flow करती है और ये hot है cold है. Next is flora and fauna of this region. It is comparatively treeless. The major crops of the major crops of this area is basically maize. That is the major crop. Maize is the major crop. Other crops including potatoes ho gaya, soya bean ho gaya, cotton and alfalfa. The grass is also growing. Large cattle farms, they are called ranches. They are basically looked by after by the sturdy men called cowboys. Bison, it is basically American buffalo. Other things they found are, for example, rabbits are there, coyotes are there, gophers are there, prairies, dog. These things are being found. The people basically carry out cultivation with a scientific method. For example, harvesters, combines, tractors are being used. And this is an area that is one of the most fertile area, as it produces a very high amount of wheat surplus that would be there. Iski wajah se in areas ko greeneries of the world ke naam se bhi jana jata hai. Dairy farming is being carried out in the Great Lakes to the east coast of the to the Atlantic coast of the east. It is famous for coal and iron region. Next is wilds. They are there where basically the grasslands which are there of South Africa region. Wilds are basically the rolling plateaus with varying heights ranging from 600 meters to 1100 meters that are found. Wilds are basically found in this region. The next is ki climate aur inme flora and fauna kaisa paya jata hai. The climate will be comparatively, jaise location dekhiye, due to the influence of the Indian Ocean yahan pe aapko dekhne ko milega. Winds are cold, but dry winds would be there. They receive rainfall in the month of basically in the summer, basically from November to February, because of the warm ocean currents that is washing the shores of the wilds that are there. Warm ocean currents are there. Flora and fauna, it is basically people are engaged into cattle raiding and mining activities. The main crop basically in this region are meat, maize, wheat, barley, oats, potatoes. The various cash crops are also grown, for example, tobacco, sugarcane, cotton. And the wool, this region is famous for the wool, and merino sheep is a popular species, and their wool is also very comparatively very warm. People, they are also engaged into dairy farming. This region is famous for iron and steel industry, and very very important is that is gold and diamond for basically the Kimberley region. Ye wala region jo aapko map mein dekh rahe hain, very famous for diamonds. The next is the 10th chapter, the life in the desert region. Desert region mein kahan kahan pe, agar desert region mein baat karte hain, the one of the famous region is the hot deserts of Sahara. The Sahara Desert, they are basically touching 11 countries: Algeria, Chad, Egypt, Libya, Mauritania, Mali, Morocco, Niger, Sudan, Tunisia, and Western Sahara. These are the 11 countries which touches the Sahara Desert. Ye dekhiye. The countries which are in this region, aapko dekhne ko milenge. Now, what is the type of climate, flora, fauna, and the people are engaged into? The climate of this region is comparatively jaise hot or very parched dry. Bahut hi kam period ke liye yahan pe short rainy season hoga. The nights may be freezing cold with the temperature कभी कभी जीरो डिग्री भी हो जाता है, ऑलमोस्ट जीरो रहता है नाइट्स में. प्लांट दैट इज देयर, फॉर एग्जांपल फ्लोरा एंड फौना, इट इज कैक्टस. बारिश कम होने की वजह से कैक्टस, डेट पाम एंड अकेशिया, दीज आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट प्लांट्स दैट वुड बी देयर. ओएसिस, ओएसिस बेसिकली एक ऐसा एरिया होता है जो कंपेरेटिवली फर्टाइल सा एरिया, जहाँ पे ग्रीन इज बेसिकली ग्रीन आइलैंड विद डेट पाम सराउंडिंग देम. वहाँ पे थोड़ी सी पानी की अवेलेबिलिटी, वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी भी होती है. कैमल्स, hyans, jackals, etc. They are basically important and that are found over here. The people of this region are basically Bedouins or Tuaregs who stay over there. The nomadic tribes there, they are basically engaged into raising livestock such as goats, sheep, camel, horses. The oases which are there in the Sahara and the Nile Valley, basically in Egypt, it is these oases that support the settled population in the region. There was a discovery of oil that was made, and because of that various important countries related to oil are Nigeria, Algeria, Libya, and Egypt. Algeria, Libya, and Egypt. The trucks are now replacing the camels in salt trade. Tuaregs, they are basically seen acting as guides to the foreign tourists who are coming to this region. तो आपको ये पूछा जा सकता है Tuaregs और Bedouins nomadic people है वो कहाँ पे पाए जाते हैं. On the other hand, there is a cold desert. They are basically the Ladakh is the cold desert lying in the Great Himalayas on the eastern side of Jammu and Kashmir region. Cold desert over here. Now the climate of this region is extremely cold and dry. It is a rain shadow of the Himalayas, and there would be freezing winds and burning hot sunlight that would be experienced as a climate. The flora and fauna, due to very high aridity, the vegetation is comparatively very little or sparse. There are scanty patches of the grasslands and shrubs of animals to graze. The groves of the willows and poplars are basically seen in the valley. Kuch important birds hai, for example, robins, red starts, Tibetan snowcock, raven and hoppy are found as important birds. Or animals mein aapko wahan pe simple, for example, wild goat ho gaya, wild sheep ho gaya, yak ho gaya, or special kinds of dogs are basically being found. People are basically either Muslims or Buddhist wahan pe kafi jyada hain. The Buddhist monastery has been there with the traditional gompas that have been very important. Some famous monasteries, for example, up say Lemuru, Hemis, Thixe, they are there. National Highway NH1A basically connect Leh to Kashmir Valley through the Zawzila Pass. So friends, these are the part 2 of NCERT of Geography Class 6, Class 7, our environment. And we would be continuing with these explanation of NCERTs and important synopsis. Those students who want to purchase it can definitely WhatsApp on the above given number. Thank you very much, friends.